In this illustration, we'll analyze a moving belt on rollers on a surface. Here the figure shows a belt of mass M on two rollers of a tractor, and if tractor moves at a speed V, we are required to find the kinetic energy of this belt. Here, to analyze the situation, we first need to consider different parts of the belt so that we'll be able to calculate their kinetic energy separately. So if we redraw the figure, if this one roller, there's another roller, and we consider the belt is having two horizontal parts and two circular parts on the two sides. So here, if the rollers are moving with the velocity v, we can consider that the circular parts would be moving with angular speed omega. And here, omega can be given as V by R if the belt is moving on cylinder in a such a way that these rollers are in pure rolling. So, in the situation, one thing we can write, if lambda be the linear mass density, of belt, here we use M should be equals to lambda multiplied by the total length of the tube, which we can write as 2L plus 2 pi R. If we consider R as the radius of roller and L is the length of horizontal sections of the belt. Now in this situation, if we calculate the kinetic energy of belt, and kinetic energy of belt is given by kinetic energy of this section, kinetic energy of this straight section, and kinetic energy of again the circular section. As this bottommost section we consider to be at rest in case of pure rolling of these rollers. So in this situation we can write, we can even split the parts as 1, 2, and 3. So we can write kinetic energy will be K1 plus K2 plus K3, which if we write here, K1 is a half ring moving with the linear speed V as well as angular speed omega. So its kinetic energy is half. Its mass we can write as lambda pi R multiplied by V square plus half. Its angular speed is omega, so we can write it as lambda pi R multiplied by R square multiplied by V square by R square. This is half I omega square. So this is the value of K1. Plus for this second part of a belt, we can see the velocity of the topmost points of the belt we can write as 2V. So in this situation, this can be given as half lambda L multiplied by 2V whole square, which is K2, plus the value of K3, which is again half a ring shaped belt. So this remains same. We can write as half lambda pi R multiplied by V square plus half lambda pi R multiplied by R square multiplied by V square by R square. Now if we simplify these terms and calculate the value of K, we'll be getting finally is lambda multiplied by 2L plus 2 pi R multiplied by V square. You can simply open these terms and simplify, you'll get it. And lambda multiplied by 2L plus 2 pi R, we can write as M. So this MV square, which is the result of this problem.